But I'm not looking to get my. I was living in Japan and the meetings and then not many of the meetings. Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulullah. وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا. اللهم زدنا علما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل: فلما قضى موسى الأجل وسار بأهله آنس من جانب السوق نارا قال لأهله إني آنست نارا لعلي آتيكم منها بخبر أو جزوة من النار لعلكم تسقطون. فلما أتاها نهي من شاطئ وادي الأيمن في البقعة المباركة من الشجرة أي يا موسى إني أنا الله رب العالمين وأن ألقي عصاك. فلما رآها تهتز كأنها جان ولا مدبرا ولم يعقب يا موسى أقبل ولا تخف إنك من الآمنين. اسلك يدك في جيبك تخرج بيضاء من غير سوء واضمم إليك جناحك من الرهب كذلك برهانان من ربك إلى فرعون وملئه إنهم كانوا قوما So this part talks about Moses' return to Egypt and how he was honored with the mission and the miracles in the way, honored with the miracle and the mission of prophethood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَمَّا قَضَى مُوسَى الْأَجَلِ When Musa alayhi salam fulfilled the term, it means that the longer of the two, you know, he said, stay with me 8, and if you be able to complete 10, that will be great. So Musa alayhi salam fulfilled the longer of the two. وَسَارَ بِأَهْلِهِ And he was traveling with his family. And they said that Musa alayhi salam missed his country and his relatives. And so he decided to go visit in secret without the Fir'aun and his people knowing. And they said that he gathered his family, he gathered some of the flocks that his father-in-law gave him, and set out in a cold, dark, rainy night. On the way, they stopped to camp. Every time he tried to make or start a fire, they said he would not succeed. Until he was surprised to see a fire from far. آنس من جانب الطور نار He saw fire from far. فقال لأهله إن كنتم إني آنست نار So he told his family to stay here. Let me just go and find out about this fire. لعلي آتيكم منها بخبر Because they were kind of lost in the desert of Sinai in Egypt. So he didn't really know the directions. So he sat naked with his people sitting around his fire. I can ask him for direction. أو جزوة من النار لعلكم تسترون Where can you get a torch of fire so that she can, you know, can warm yourself? It was a cold night. And there's actually a report that it says that Moses' wife was pregnant. And she was actually happy in her pregnancy. And فَلَمَّا آتَاهَا نُوْلِيَ مِنْ شَاطِئِ الْوَادِ الْأَيْمَنِ When Musa alayhi salam reached the fire, you know, he heard the voice. And by the way, it wasn't really a fire, like the fire that we have. It was light. It was light. And he was just like stunned, and he froze, stood right there, staring at it. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, من وما فلما أتاه نوري من شاطئ وادي أيمن When he arrived to the fire, he was called from the right side of the valley. وما كنت بجانب الغربي قرينا إلى موسى الأمر رسول الله سبحانه وتعالى said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم We weren't there when we spoke to Musa عليه السلام and we gave him the command of you know, being a prophet take the message to the Pharaoh and his people. Right? فلما أتاها نودي أن الله سبحانه وتعالى كون نسواني بسفاني مبارك. It's a blessed dawah. Why it's a blessed dawah? It's the Jabal al-Tur, the mountain of Tur in Sinai, in Egypt. Why it is called blessed dawah? It's blessed because that's where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa alayhi salam. So automatically it is a blessed place. A place in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to one of his servants, one of his prophets, and gave him the mission to go and, you know, direct his people, deliver them from the oppression of the Pharaoh, and also convey the message to the Pharaoh and his people. So that's why it's called Mubarak. And the Shajara, what is the Shajara? What is that tree? You know, some people, there is actually a tree, there is a city in Egypt called St. Catherine. And they have a big monastery there, and there is a tree in there. They surrounded this tree with, you know, with stuff to keep people away from it. You know, have signs all over the place, don't touch, don't take anything. And they say that this tree doesn't really grow anywhere else in Sinai. And they even took like some seeds, and they tried to implant the seed somewhere else, it didn't grow. But Allah A'lam, if this is really the tree that Musa alayhi salam saw, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa and knew this tree, and the Muslims and the Christians, they go and visit this place. You know, and but wallahi, Allah A'lam, there's really no, there's no proof that this is really for certainty that this is the tree which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa. Some scholars actually, they said the tree is Shajar of Zaytun. You know, the olive tree. Olive tree were called also in the Quran in a different occasion as a blessed tree. And Sinai is known for that. It's known for the good production of, you know, the olive trees. So it could be the olive tree, Allah ma'am. So we don't really know exactly where or what type of tree is this tree. There's absolutely nothing for certainty in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, to describe this tree or tell you for sure what this tree is. Anyway, when Musa alayhi salam came to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, told him, now Musa, inni ana Allah rabbul alamin. I am the Lord of the universe. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa. And that was the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or one of the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Musa alayhi salam. Yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called Ibrahim Khalil Allah, in a defender of Allah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, وَأَنَا قَيْدَ الْخَلِيلِ اللَّهِ and I'm also the Khalil of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called Isa alayhi salam, Rauh Allah, the Spirit of Allah. Right? And Musa alayhi salam is what? Kaleem Allah, the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to. It's such a great honor for him to be called Kaleem Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to him, وَأَنْ أَلْقِي عَصَاكَ. You know, cast your, throw your hay. And in one surah, in surah Taha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ مُوسَى. What is that that you have in your hand? He said, إِنَّهَا عَصَاي. قَالَ هِيَ عَصَاي. أَتَوَكَّأُ عَلَيْهَا وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَى غَنَمِي. It's my stake, it helps me walking. And also, I hush biha ala ghanami. You know how the shepherds, when they pass a tree, they hit the branches with their stick, you know? And so that, you know, whatever the tree falls down and then the cattle eat, the flocks eat, that's a hush. That's me. You know? I use it to walk, and I hush biha ala ghanami. I hit the branches of the trees for my sheep. وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآلِبُ أُخْرَى. And I use it also for other purposes. قَالَ أَلْقِيهَا يَا مُوسَى. Throw it on Musa. فَإِذَا هِيَ حَيَّةٌ تَسْعَى. And by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it turned into a massive, huge snake. That Musa alayhi salam, really, he turned around, وَلَّا مُدْبِرًا وَلَمْ يُعَقِّلْ. You know, he turned around and he fled. And this is just a human nature, a human response to something like that. You know, you stay away from trouble. You know, you see something like that, a predator or a beast, you run away from it. Right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they said that it was massive, massive snake. Ibn Kathir said that it was crushing the
you know, rocks in front of Musa alayhi salam with its jaw. You know, and when it swallows a rock, he feels as if the rock makes a big, massive noise, as if the rock it falls off of a valley or something. So seeing something like that in a night like that, he was so scared, and so he ran away. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him and he said, don't be scared. La takhaf. Right? سَنُعِيدُهَا سِيرَتَهَا الْأُولَى. Right? Grab it and we will return it back to its original state. So grab it from the top of it. The top is the jaw of the snake. So he had to put his hand in the mouth of the snake. So he did that and then it settled. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turned back to its original state. SubhanAllah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is one sign. The other sign, put your hand into, you know, your garment or the pocket of your garment, and it will come out as it is a piece of the moon, right? As if it's a piece of the moon. And there is a report that it says, min ghayri su', without any disease, without any problem. Some people, and this is just, you know, one of the Israeliyat, it doesn't really have any source in our religion, but it says that Musa alayhi salam had leprosy in his hand. And so he was concerned that if he would go to Musa alayhi salam, if he goes to the Pharaoh, you know, the Pharaoh will just, you know, point out some flaws, also some physical flaws. So he was concerned about that, and some people, they said he was shy about it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to put your hand in your pocket and take it out and be free from any disease or any leprosy or anything like that. That I did not find in a very, you know, strong, liable type of report. You know, so Allah, nobody should could be just from any scratch or anyone or anything like that. Or just an ayah, just a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who puts his hand in his pocket and all of a sudden it comes out like light, like ice? Nobody. So it is a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take to the Pharaoh and his people. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, وَضْمُمْ يَلَكَ إِلَى جَنَاحَكَ مِنَ الرَّحْمِ. And draw your hand close to your chest every time you fear anything. So from now on, you're going to have to deal with this snake. So anytime that you feel scared of it, just put your hand in your chest like that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove that terror. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove that fear. Right? And when you go to the Pharaoh, anytime you feel scared of anything, just put your hand in your chest. And some people, actually, some scholars, they said, we also should do that. And it could be that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove the fear and the terror or the anxiety that you have. Or at least Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. Right? So we'll continue tomorrow, inshallah. JazakAllah khair. By the way, yesterday the hadith, يتزوج حفصة من هو خير من أبي بكر وعمر ويتزوج عثمان من هي خير من حفصة ويتزوج عثمان because عمر went to عثمان so ويتزوج عثمان من هي خير من حفصة عثمان married the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم had a forgot us last night جزاكم الله خير continue tomorrow inshallah
السلام عليكم جزاكم الله خير